it? The 22nd of April, I think. And this morning it was a very hard frost. So things in the garden, to be honest with you, they've been a bit slow. But that's probably from my perspective, because I get to sort of come out and walk out into the garden on a daily basis, and you don't sort of see much change when you look at it from day to day. But over a longer period of time, there has been a change, and you'll notice it. So this is the garden update from the 22nd of April. So first of all, we'll look at the beds one at a time. I've actually started in a third bed. You can see it over there. So as and when compost becomes available and cardboard, because I've got to reclaim the land from the grass and I use the cardboard as a mulch, I'll be bringing that bed hopefully all the way along to this point here, so that'll be the growing space. So there are the beds. So first up from the beds, we've got some good lettuce. I've already had a harvest of lettuce, a small harvest. I've also got lettuce in the greenhouse. We'll look at those in a minute. But interspersed with the lettuce are beetroot. Some of them are getting nibbled by something, I'm not sure what. Foxes are coming in and digging holes. It seems most days they've dug something up. I've got radishes over there. Let's have a look at the radishes, because there's something funny going on over there. So what's happening with the radishes? Well, you can see these are doing very well, and there's a nice large one there. I'll be harvesting that one later on today. But just coming a couple of feet away, these were planted at the same time and they've done hardly anything. And also I've got a lot of this sort of fungus growing as well. Some sort of a cup fungus, I'm not sure what it is. I had loads of it, but it seems to be diminishing now. So that could be an indicator that there's still material in the compost which is still breaking down, and maybe that's the reason why the plants here aren't getting the nutrients. But this compost over here was a bit different. So I mean, look at the size of that. And the lettuces over there have done better as well. Everything on this bed, this side, has done better. But moving away down this end, I've got another mixture of spring onions. Some of them have done well, some of them haven't. I mean, they're coming on nicely. Next door, not very good. A fair amount of spring onion in there. So mostly in this bed, spring onions. Maybe the odd marble. Fox poo. Beetroot. Some of the beetroot's done well, but as I say, you can see the transition from this side of the bed. Nothing much growing. More of that fungi. More of it down there. To this side of the bed, and then the beetroot here is doing better. The beetroot there is doing better. The lettuce is doing very well. Moving across to the next bed along. So this bed has a mixture of perpetual spinach, and then we've got the fennel, onions, these are sets, and peas. So a quick look at the perpetual spinach. Some of it's doing quite well, still not, it's still early in the season, you know, so still a lot of growing to happen. In places some of it hasn't done so well. But again, variation, I think, in the quality of the compost. The fennel is doing surprisingly well. Beautiful plants. I mean, there's three of them there. I had a good germination of the fennel, so I'm quite looking forward to tasting some of that in a few weeks' time. The onions, these were sets because I grew some from seeds and they seemed to have very poor germination, but in actual fact I did get a few onions from them, which are seedlings, which are growing on. I'll show you those in a minute. But these are growing from sets, so hopefully they'll make bulbs at some point later on in the year. You can see in the surface the texture of the soil is a lot different because I've added charcoal, activated biochar. So it'd be interesting to see again how the plants in this section of the bed do. Lastly, the far end of the bed, peas. I did grow these for pea shoots, but I don't know if I'm going to just let them grow on for pods. I'm not sure what sort of a harvest I'm going to get from them, to be honest with you. Maybe peas weren't the best crop to plant. If you want a big return of food, maybe peas aren't the best for a small space. Okay, we'll move on to the bed over there, the third bed rather. In this bed here, I've sowed parsnips, and they're taking ages to germinate. Parsnips do take a long time to germinate, so I've been told. And so they've been under a layer of cardboard to keep the top of the surface from drying out, to give the seeds a chance to germinate. I have dug down and found two or three of the seeds, and they are beginning to sprout. So I think it won't be very long until we see the actual seedlings beginning to pop their heads above the surface. So moving on. More lettuces. I do like my lettuces, but you can see diggings. Mr. Fox has been here digging away. Over there as well, look. But the plants seem to be surviving, they're standing up. I've lost two or three, that's to be expected, but I should certainly get a reasonable harvest of good fresh lettuce from that. I've got more lettuce growing in the greenhouse, and I'll show you that in a minute. Remember, I mentioned just a few minutes ago about the onions. Well, I grew some from seed, and here they are, tiny little seedling onions that I transplanted. I transplanted these about a week ago, 10 days ago, and they're all standing up now, and they're stir on, so they should be onions for bulbs, and hopefully I'll get a good harvest of those in due course. The fourth bed is empty at the moment, but I'm going to be adding beetroot and Swiss chard to that, I think. The box down here, it's got potatoes planted in it, so there's a couple of potato plants in a cardboard box. Apparently cardboard boxes work quite well. I've got more seed potatoes planted in other containers around the side of the property, and I got my carrots, which are beginning to germinate as well. They're also in a tub, hopefully to keep the carrot root fly out. But that little devil, I've been told, will get everywhere. So anyway, we'll do what we can. Let's have a look in the greenhouse. So here we are in the greenhouse. The composter's churning away nicely. I have removed the bottom door to look at the compost. It all holds on quite firm, to be honest with you. So that's the layers of compost. It's gone cold. The top part of the bin is at temperature, is quite high, but as it composts down, it cools down and just becomes like this. And I wouldn't say it's fully composted yet, although I'm probably going to hook some of this out and put it elsewhere to let it rot down further, and then add it to the beds later on in the year. There's a woodlouse there, look. You see the woodlouse? He's crawling in amongst there, doing his whatever he does. Leaving to his little life. Let's take a quick look on the inside of the compost at the top here. That's where we're at with it. So, can you see that? We're just in the warm at 30 degrees C at the moment, so it's still working away in the top part, but as I say, the bottom part has gone cold, so possibly going to hook some of that out later on. Down on the floor, the beds in the greenhouse are full of lettuce, and I've already had some lettuce off of these. I tend to sort of get hold of a leaf. The lower down leaves, they're getting a bit damaged now, and I don't see the reason why I just can't pinch it off like that. And I've got a nice leaf. So I'll collect a few more leaves that I think the plant can do without, and then leave the rest of the plant to grow on. I've also got radishes growing in here as well, but in the next month this will all be coming out and I'll be making way for my tomato plants. And tomato plants done very well, actually. I may have started them off a bit too soon, but something interesting is happening with those as well. I've got more lettuces over this side. That one there is doing really well. That's a good strong lettuce there. And I've put these small tomato plants here, I've put them in the greenhouse early because they were growing in these modules and they were getting a bit root bound, and I didn't have any spare pots, so I thought, just for the time being, I'll stick them in there, and if they survive, well, good luck to them. If they don't, I haven't lost anything because I've got so many tomato plants that I don't know what to do with them all. Well, here they are. We're in the conservatory now. But something interesting has happened. You'll notice a variation in sizes. I mean, look at this. These are all from the same seed packet, all sown at the same time. I've got that plant there in a plastic pot. And that's 8 inches tall now. And all the plants that I transplanted into these cardboard pots, look at that poor thing. That hasn't done very well at all. Same age, same packet of seeds, but it seems that the plants that have been put into the cardboard pots haven't done so well. They're all like that. I mean, one or two have done better. That one there, for example, is a good strong plant. Not big, but a good strong plant. But that one there obviously is not very good at all. It's yellow. I'm not sure why, all the same compost. Not sure what's going on there. That plant's just got damage, I noticed. There's a leaf snapped on it. But luckily the growing point is intact. So again, plastic pots. And the seedlings are stronger. So I've probably got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 tomato plants that I'm probably going to use. The ones that haven't done well, I'm probably going to discard them. If anyone's wondering what these are Ailsa Craig. They're all Ailsa Craig, if that means anything to you. Our time's moved on a little bit. I just made myself a nice cup of tea. Lovely, sat in the greenhouse. Enjoying a nice cup of tea that I made on my little Transia camping stove. I do like that little stove. Find it. I've got lots of stoves in my collection of camping equipment, but the one that I use the most, it's just so practical, is the little Transia, because it's it completely folds down. It's got nesting pots. It's got a lovely little kettle. It just seems to sort of come on most of my trips with me. On this occasion, it's come out on a trip to the greenhouse, where I'm again surveying the ground, and I'm glad to say the sun has finally come out and it's a beautiful, beautiful day. In fact, I'll be taking this jacket off in a minute, it's getting so warm. The problem is though, we've got a great discrepancy in temperature now. Very, very hot when the sun comes out during the daytime, but very cold at night. Last night, as I said, it went down to below zero. There was quite a hard frost here. Right, anyway, I want to show you something whilst I'm in the greenhouse, because I use it as a place where I store some of my gardening equipment. First of all, the weeding. I've started to have to do a little bit of hoeing on the beds, and I've been using this tool. It's a hand hoe, possibly even described as an onion hoe perhaps, but I can really get in very accurately with that, and not sever the roots off of my crops, but I can weed out the unwanted plants. The other thing is, I've got this is a dibber, it's got markers on it, a plastic dibber, but I've also found that it's good for making seed drills. And just cast your mind back a few minutes ago in this video, and I showed you a new bed that I'd was in the process of creating. Well, since filming that to now, I've actually planted that bed up, and I've planted it up with beetroot, because I feel that I need more beetroot. And the ones that I put down in the first bed weren't as good as I was hoping they would be. So I've planted over 100 beetroot seeds, believe it or not, and I've used that to form the drills, and then I spaced the drills. This seems to be about the right sort of spacing for a lot of plants, really. It's a piece of half pipe or a piece of plastic guttering. I lay that on the ground, and it gives me the ideal spacing between rows. So that's what I've done. So I've got loads more beetroot planted. I do enjoy beetroot. It's a lovely vegetable. One of my favourites, I think. Yep. So anyway, I'm going to enjoy my cup of tea. I hope you've enjoyed the garden tour of April, and I expect, fingers crossed, that there's going to be a lot more growth over the next sort of 4 to 6 weeks. So I'll bring you back again maybe in 2 to 3 weeks, 4 weeks at the latest, and we'll see how things are moving on with the little kitchen garden here at 2 acres. Anyway, yeah. Thanks for watching. If you've enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't enjoyed it, then give it a thumbs down. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now. Are you supposed to wash him? Mmm.